What's up guys, welcome to Tech Breakdown, the series where we are going to break down every leaks and rumors of the tech industry episode. But today, we are going to unveiling the leaks about the all-new iPhone 12 and some new PS5 controllers. So grab some popcorn, get ready, let's get started.
Welcome to the Tech Breakdown.
The first thing which we've gotten here is the all-new PS5 controllers. So there is a history of PS controllers that from PS1 to PS3, the controllers were identically the same, except for a little bit minor changes, and in PS3 they made it wireless. PS4 controller were similar but a minor with LED and a little bit of modernized. And the old controller were known as DualShock controllers, but with PS5 everything is going to change. The new PS5 controller is the name as DualSense controller instead of DualShock controllers, and in terms of design they have changed this year. Now, a completely new design, they are coming up with the combination of Xbox and PlayStation combined together. The design of the PS5 controller is really cool, and I myself prefer over Xbox this controller because it looks super cool. Another thing which we are having here is the wireless charger from OnePlus. So if you guys are not familiar, that OnePlus 8 series will be supporting the wireless charging technology. And if you don't know that, go check out the recent video which I uploaded, the first episode of Tech Breakdown, which I am going to tell you each and everything about the OnePlus 8 series. Complete this video, go check out this video, that video is also good, and don't forget to subscribe. But 30 watt wireless charging is going to support it, but today we are having the images of how the wireless charging is going to be looking from the OnePlus. It is really cool that wireless charging is now coming to the OnePlus, and wireless charger itself, I don't like it that much. It is sort of a knockoff Pixel stand, but the best wireless charger which I can recommend is always the Pixel stand. So alongside with the OnePlus, OnePlus is also going to launch the new OnePlus Bullet Wireless Z. And OnePlus recently tweeted that the OnePlus Bullet Wireless Z, the charging capacity is you can charge for 10 minutes and get a playback of 10 hours. And the total capacity was going to be around 20 hours of playback. So it is going to be really good. But the thing which is surprising for me is after seeing a little bit of images, I think they are going to be the neckband instead of completely wireless. Like we were suggesting from AirPods, like AirPods something, it is not happening. It is going to be neckband. Another thing is actually the Samsung. We are having Samsung patented that they are going with the quad curve design. So S20, S20 Plus and S20 Ultra was the least favorite phones of mine because they have gone from steeper edge to almost vanishing the edge. And I know that I am a huge fan of edge displays, although they are worthless, they are not using anything, but it looks really good. But after seeing that patent, one Samsung is patenting for quad curved display actually, which Huawei was going to do with P40 Pro, but they failed drastically. But when it comes to Samsung, we have seen that Note Edge was not practical, nobody liked it, but that thing leaves awesome phones from S6 Edge to S8 to S10, not S20. But this thing, which is going to be the quad edge display, I am like looking into it, how Samsung is going to push the screen industries again. The burning news today is from Apple. The Apple just leaked of the iOS 14, which is coming with the iPhone 12. But the thing is, in iOS 14, we are going to have the tile-like designs, which are smaller icons, which we're seeing in the patents. I don't know what it is, but it seems that that patent, we are having a smaller notch into the iPhone. And after seeing that, I was so happy that finally Apple is running with the industry in technology, not just for the processors. We know we are having punch-hole cameras from 120Hz displays to crazy sharpness. In Android industry, we got really good displays, but for Apple, we are stuck with that huge notch, which I hated. But finally we are not getting a punch hole camera, but we are having at least a smaller notch. And another thing which we are having, that we are also getting the triple camera setup, not quad camera setup in the iPhone 12, but instead we are getting a LiDAR sensor, which we have seen from the new iPad Pros for 2020. Same sensor is going to be baked into the iPhone 12. So not much drastic difference, but yeah, the difference is going to be mostly in the display, like smaller notch and maybe 120Hz ProMotion display. Let's see what is happening. So this is the episode 2 of Tech Breakdown. If you like it, smash that like button down below. Subscribe to this channel. I'll catch you guys in the very next video of the Tech Breakdown.